What's up, YouTube? Jeff back again today. Another very exciting Samsung video for you guys. And today we have something very special. We are waiting on One UI 6.0 beta to go live with lots of new features, but Samsung has pushed an update to one of their GoodLock apps early that shows us a sneak peek of something that we were expecting in One UI 6.0, which means you can go ahead and already get this on any Galaxy phone that runs the GoodLock module LockStar. Before we get started, I want to remind you guys that if you are interested in ordering anything from Samsung Unpacked this month, go check out my website and order a mystery box. It's 100% free in the US. You get a free case, a phone stand, cleaning kit. All the details are on my website. All you have to do is use my affiliate link to order, send me your proof of purchase that you bought something from Samsung using my link, and we ship them out. So, one thing we've been looking for a long time on Android, we had, a long time ago, lock screen widgets, and then they got rid of them. And then Apple got lock screen widgets on the iPhone, and now everybody wants them again. I always like lock screen widgets personally, so I'm really happy that we finally have them back. So in order to get these, you're gonna have to use GoodLock, and you're gonna have to use the module LockStar. Now, this is an update that has not really rolled out everywhere yet. I actually made a video about the Navstar update, which also is down there. This is not rolled out to all phones. In fact, my unlocked Galaxy S23 Ultra, which is my lime green one over here, that one does not have the update. This is my AT&T version. And what I did is I went ahead and downloaded the APK from Vitrox over on Twitter, Vitrox360. I talk about him all the time on the channel. He does Samsung content, leaks about software. He's a great follow. And I downloaded the APK. He uploaded it using Samsung QuickShare. So I trust him. I'm going to link it below if you want to download it. But you can also wait for the update. I'm just saying, I trust him, so I downloaded it, but always do your due diligence, of course. So what this update brings is the ability to add lock screen widgets to your lock screen in Samsung One UI. So here is the lock screen, and you'll notice right here, some pretty typical stuff. You got your quick toggles down here, system messages, fingerprint scanner, notifications, clock, and then the system icons at the top. And then if you tap on this, you'll see right here, this is a widget. So this is the Google Keep widget, and I can change the size of it, make it smaller or larger. It is confined to this predetermined rectangle, so the sizing is kind of weird right now. If you go tap down here, you can see the transparency. You can actually change the transparency of the widget. And then you can also go into the settings, and you can change different, obviously change different notes. In this case, I have a Google Keep note. But you can change all the settings depending on what widget it is. So I'll go through and add another one just to show you guys the process. So just tap anywhere in the blank area. And before, of course, you had the option to add a sticker, add the regular music player, but now you can add any widget from these predetermined apps. Now there's obviously a lot of apps on here. You can do pretty much any social medias, weather, YouTube, pretty much all the widgets that you could do on the home screen, you can now also do here as well. So some of the ones that I think will be very popular with people, particularly YouTube and YouTube Music, you can add your, YouTube Music widget right there on the home on your screen, and you can add multiple widgets. So if I want to add that one, but then let's say I also want a battery widget, I can add both of them. So then here it'll tell you devices to show, whether you want to match with dark mode, etc. Now I will say that if you actually look at this, if you add two widgets, the sizing can get kind of wonky because the widgets together have to basically both be confined to this one little box area here. And that certainly makes the sizing a little weird. So you can't really make them both necessarily the size that you want. I don't know if this will be fixed in One UI 6.0 proper or if eventually they'll update it in the LockStar app itself. You can kind of see right here, I haven't opened YouTube Music on this one, so it's grayed out. See the battery toggles up there. This is one I mainly use for like testing software and stuff. So I don't have all my apps queued up on it, but unfortunately I don't like installing like testing stuff on my main phone because then what if it doesn't work or causes some issues? The cool thing is you can also do these widgets not only on the lock screen, which is what I just showed you over here. And again, you can keep adding more, but the problem is you're gonna run into a size consideration issue. Like, let's actually do it. Let's add a third one. And then let's add this as a widget. Now you can see, like, they're all, like, confined to this little box. And it can get really messy pretty quickly. So now you can also do this though on your always on display, which is over here on the right. So you can see here, I have a weather widget, which looks pretty nice. And it's the same sort of idea. The only constraint here though, with the always on display, which is really important, is that you cannot move around the notification icons or the fingerprint sensor, obviously, or this guy at the bottom. You can't move it all around like you can on the lock screen. So your widgets are gonna be confined to this little area right here, which is gonna be determined based on the clock that you have. Of course, you could make a clock that has less screen real estate, then you have more room for widgets. But I think I like the weather myself. So you can kind of see here, it looks really nice on the always on display. And the animation from here to the always on display is also nice. I'll show you guys that. It really depends on the clock that you have installed, but the animation on some of these is quite nice. If you don't have the correct clock, and if you install too many widgets, in fact here, the animation's a little jarring. This is definitely not perfect, but earlier I just had one widget here and one widget on the lock screen, on the always on display. And the transition from always on display to the actual screen was actually fairly smooth. And of course, if you have clocks that match, that also kind of helps too. So hopefully Samsung will improve those things. Obviously, there's still some issues with the scaling, some issues with everything being confined in one box, but I don't really know what they can do about that. If you want to make it customizable, but also have other problems, you know, with how many you have, you don't want to be able to add unlimited widgets because that would cause some issues as well. Anyway, I want to show you guys an early look. I would imagine we're going to eventually see perhaps native support in One UI 6 for this, or at least some extra support baked into One UI 6 that helps with the Lockstar customization, just like we do the touch to hold in One UI 5 that came out. So stay tuned for that. Anyway, like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification icon for future videos like this. Do appreciate my son Jonathan for letting us hang out with the baby T-Rex and the red and green T-Rex over here. Appreciate you guys checking out the video. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks a lot for watching.